It can feel like the climate is changing faster than we can react, but there are people doing good work. There is a climate crew.
There really is something special with the loons. There is something mysterious about them, about the way they vocalize. As soon as you go on a lake or in the forest, I think everybody hopes to hear the loons. They are part of our contact with nature. They are a part of our Canadian identity.
I'm Marc-André Valiquette. I'm the ecologist team leader at La Mauricie National Park.
Things you probably didn't know about the common loon. They spend their winters on the Atlantic Ocean. They return to the lakes to breed and raise their young. Eggs laid in early May will hatch in early July. A baby loon is called a loonlet. Parents will help feed the young until it's time for fall migration, and then the young are on their own. Unlike most birds, they have solid bones, which helps them be such great divers. But like most birds, loons are feeling the impact of our changing climate and increased human activity in their nesting grounds.
A good loon population is a sign of a healthy ecosystem. They regulate fish and other organism population the same way the wolf do this with the deer in the forest. That's why we can refer to the loon as the wolf of the lake.
I think I see them there. Yes. I see one young.
There is only one young, but we had two eggs in June. So we will go back at the nest to see what's happened to the second egg. But actually the water level is really, really high. So we won't find the nest because it might be actually floods.
Are the nests hard to find?
When there's no loon on the nest, they're hard to find because they're just a small depression in the vegetation. When the eggs are there, they are greenish, really camouflage, so it's hard to spot. And they are really close to the water because the feet of the loon are really at the tip of his abdomen, so he's not able to walk on the ground. So usually we found the nest in the first meter next to the water level.
Are there a lot of nests in the park?
We are doing a survey on 17 lakes, and we are finding every year 10 to 12 breeding pair on those 17 lakes. We can extrapolate that we have from 30 to 35 breeding pair in the national park.
Through monitoring the loon nests and their conservation efforts, they've been able to double the breeding pairs in the park, but...
We have fewer young loon because the eggs are not hatching. That's the main problem. There's three main reasons affecting loon reproduction success. Heavy rain we have during the incubation period that flood the nest, water quality, especially acidification, and disturbance by visitors.
The crew enacted some key measures to help the loons, and for the first time since 1987, they've had improvement in the number of loonlets surviving. That success is attributed to having closed areas to visitors to minimize disturbance and the installation of floating islands as nesting sites.
So this is the floating island that you build?
Yeah, we build them during the winter on the ice. We put a flotation device, then build a wooden platform over it. And in the spring, we put some branch and shrubs to be sure to have a nice island with vegetation to hide the loon from predator. So, and every year we put some more vegetation just to be sure that it maintains a natural look. And because this platform adjusts to the water level, so even if we have a lot of rain during the incubation period, they're good here.
Finding the membrane from the egg is a sure sign there was a successful hatching and it wasn't consumed by a predator. The thick layer provides protection and oxygen exchange for the growing loonlet, which is why if the nest floods, the egg is no longer viable.
So they leave the nest and they don't come back?
Yeah, they live in the water. They are not attached to the nest as soon as the chicks are able to float by themselves after a few hours.
Oh, we can hear their call. Are they distressed?
No, that's the usual call. Sometimes we can hear a really short call. It's one of the adults calling the chicks to him, so they have really different vocalization. But now we are far away and they are relaxed. or works with the loon help understand the effect of climatic change on the aquatic ecosystem. The more we know, the more we will take conservation measurement to help the loon in changing worlds. This year was a good example. We had a really early spring, so the loon nest earlier than usual. That's part of climate change. But as they nest sooner than usual, most of them escape the flooding from the heavy rain in June. Things are changing, but things are adapting too.